Good evening all. So we have come back with a very interesting topic, and this topic is about A levels, or what is equivalent for an A levels degree. This degree is the degree that people usually tend to take or tend to study for at the age between 16 and 18. And it's different in the Middle East than anywhere else in the world, because in the Middle East it's only 1 year. So your 12th year, actually the one that in most countries, the one that contribute to your GPA or points or whatever grade. So the final grade will be determined by this year. On this topic, I will start talking. So this year is a very special year in the Middle East, the 12th year. When you reach your 12th grade, you are in a position that you have to go through formal exams that are coming from the ministries. And in many cases, they are even corrected by the ministries. So by the Ministry of Education. And based on the results of these exams, you will be judged whether what will be your major in the university, or what kind of grades you will be getting. So what kind of specialization you will study, as there are a lot of competition on some topics like medicine and some kinds of engineering. The people who get the higher grades, they tend to be able to enter these specialization or to enter the university, while the others who could not achieve the high grades, maybe they go and join the workforce through a skilled program or through a college degree or through something that is less than the university. So there is a great significance on this degree and what you and your results out of this degree and your position in the society as a result of this degree. So what happens is that in Jordan, by the age of 10, in your 10th grade, by the age of 15, you will be chosen whether you have a scientific interest or a literature interest. Whether you are interested in studying things related to math and science and physics, geology and so on, or you are interested in studying things that are related to literature, law, Arabic, Islamic studies, could be history, politics and so on. So by the 10th grade, you choose whether you will be specialized in scientific topics or you'll be specialized in art related topics. Then by the 12th year, your 12th grade, your 12th year in the university, you are subjected to this exam. In Jordan, the scientific discipline, which I have gone through, usually there are 10 subjects. Four of them are scientific and one is physics, geology, chemistry and biology, and one mathematics, and five general, which are about computer science, Arabic, English, Islamic studies and general culture. So this is the studies that this is the topics that you will study, and this is the topics that you will go through an exam with. And based on your results and based on your exam results, you will be selected whether you will be in a position to enter the university and what kind of specialization you will enter. In other colleges and other schools, it's completely different. So there is A levels, and there are and this system is about choosing group of topics that based on this topic actually help you to enter a particular topic in the university. So they are a bridge. So they are a bridge between the high school is not actually the determinant factor or the testing instrument or it's something that prepares you for the university. So if you want to study medicine or something related to the medical field, you will go and study topics like biology, chemistry, maybe you'll go with math, and maybe a fourth topic could be anatomy, or could be physiology. And by studying these, this will prepare you to enter a medical field in the university or a medical discipline. Could be nursing, could be experiments analysis, or this medical analysis, could be becoming a doctor, or could be something with related to x-ray specialist or prosthetics specialist and so on. But these kinds of discipline is not actually there for to judge you, but it's there to prepare you to enter the university. Now, based on your marks, different university accept different levels. So some universities will demand that in the three topics that you have chosen, you should be three A's, you should be five A's. So if you want to study medicine in the university of, let us say, Yale, there should be, this is a top university, all of your topics you should be straight A's. So you should get straight A's, and sometimes they would even look at the grade, not only the letter, they will look at the grade, should be straight A's, A's at the old A's and 90. So they will, they, you will be demanded based on university. But if you want to study medicine in another university, maybe they will say, okay, you need two B's and one A. So the level of the university and the name of the university is differ from one university to another, but the topics that you study does not affect what you are going to study as much as it's affect where you will be studying them. So some universities will demand very high marks and other universities will demand less marks. And some universities have high tuition fees, other universities have different tuition fees. So this results actually is not only associated with tuition fees as much they are associated with the university that you will be getting and the specialization you will be getting and the topics you will be studying. The benefits of our system, that the general exam of general topics, is it's the benefit of having a tool, a justice-based tool to assess different students and to give them a better opportunity in life. In our society, a doctor have a much better prospect in his life more than, let me say, a construction worker. In other societies, yes, it's the same, but the level of difference is not as wide. And sometimes even doctor, most of doctors, for example, can be working for the government. In our society, many doctors work for the private sector. So it's a discussion about where you will be getting in life and what you will be where you will be heading. So in our society, this exam is about social justice and it's about giving the best students the opportunity to study the best topics, while in other countries, it's about preparing the students for the university, regardless what they will be doing after. I think our current system is okay as a assessment tool, as a just assessment tool, but I think there are other tools that should be included to understand the person in a better way and direct him and guide him for things that he likes and for things and for specialization that he will be very good at doing. It's always a stressful year, whether it was A levels or the general, secondary school diploma or the general secondary school diploma. It's always a very important tool, and it's always a tool that it's always a very tough year that all the students think about, and they start to gather all of their efforts to get the highest mark possible, because they understand they will be judged at least partially based on these results. So for those who are doing their A-levels or for those who are doing their high school exams or their secondary high school exams, I wish you good luck and all the best, and I wish you a great success. That was my talk on A-levels and general the high school exam, or what is called A-levels in many countries. We'll see you in another video, and for now we'll say salam.